Yes.
Is it a live streaming on YouTube?
No. It is not live now. Okay, good morning all the participants of this summer program on additive manufacturing. So time flies very fast and we are into the last day. So we had started it on 11th of May, and there have been a variety of lectures on different topics. Some of the top corporates in the domain, like Stratasys, Renishaw, Wipro3D, some top academicians, researchers, NML Jamshedpur, AKTU, and professional society. And now we So it is very interesting that we end the session by a talk on intellectual property, because ultimately that is what it matters actually. So irrespective of the fact whether anyone is how much technically knowledgeable, or someone is holding how much capital, but it is basically when you scale the idea or make any innovation commercial, then only basically things work. And nowadays, Indian ecosystem is very interesting. For example, in terms of number of startups, I think we rank somewhere top 10 in the world. And second interesting part is that a majority of these startups are driven by very, very young talent. So as a engineering student, whichever year you are, there is a whole lot of opportunities lying ahead. Whatever be the situation, for example, the current situation, although not very I will say, for example, it is going against the economy in certain respect, but still people have exploited the situation. They have come up with several ideas. For example, ventilator, for example, probably we never heard this word so often, but now it is just ventilator, ventilator everywhere. Like that. So there is a opportunity in a difficult situation. Okay, so I will introduce the speaker. I welcome Preeti Kasbi, and I thank her for accepting our invite for the benefit of the students and faculty members. She's Director and Chief Research Strategic Officer at TCIS India. She is an international speaker speaking on strategic aspects of amalgamating IT, cyber law, and business in Industry 4.0 era. She is active speaker at tech global conferences and actively participating in ITU regulatory workshops and initiatives on sustainable development goals and CSIR theses. She is a problem solver, business strategist with 15 plus years of experience. She is a seasoned R&D strategist with expertise in Internet of Things, AI, machine learning, software, hardware products, fintech, blockchain, big data. So these are, as we all know, these are all these are the hot areas of today. She's working with ITU Geneva, which is a telecom arm of UN, as a technology strategist. Is facilitating digital skills and technology education through UN training programs designed to address human and technical capacity challenges with special focus on Industry 4.0. Transforming information into more plausible understanding data metrics is her USP. She is qualified patent professional under Ministry of Commerce, and she is alumni of University of Delhi. So I welcome, thanks again for accepting our invite. Now the control is with you.
Thank you, Dr. Shiv, for this introduction, and thank you for inviting me to speak on a very important topic. And I think intellectual capacity of every individual is there, and the time is very apt where each one of us is able to focus on the intellectual capacity, or what we all know as intellectual property, right? So today, I'll be discussing about what all parts of intellectual capacity can be protected in India and globally, and how each one of you can be your own boss. I would say entrepreneurship comes with a lot of resources, and how each one of you can be a resource is the outcome of this presentation. So as you see, the ambit of today is what to expect is to identify your own purpose. So when we talk about intellectual property rights, I think we have a chat box here. So I will try and ask questions, and maybe you guys can actually write in the chat box and we can discuss, and let's keep it very interactive rather than just one way of communication, because I think each one of us is going to learn something from this workshop, and this is only going to work when it's a two-way communication. Having said that, my first question to each one of you is, what is intellectual property right for you? You can write in the chat box and we can start the discussion from there. Your understanding of intellectual property rights. If any of you can write in the chat box is open in front of me, and we will start from here. Because every business model is driven by some kind of branding. Every business model is driven by some kind of strategy. And I'm sure since 11th of May, you have gone through so many lectures and workshops. So you might be having some kind of ideation in your mind. Ideation in your mind that ideas per se can be driven by way of doing businesses. So yes, idea when given a tangible format, it forms some part of intellectual property, right? So Arun Kumar wrote, ideas is all about our notions and ideas. So notion is basically the creation of what you create with your own mind, and which is different from others, is going to drive your business. Like Dr. Shiv talked about the ventilator. Nobody a year back ever talked about a ventilator, or nobody a year back talked about masks. However, today, if you see the opportunity in the business arena, you will see a lot of people are manufacturing masks. A lot of people or startups in India, the stakeholders in India, they are investing in ventilators so that it can solve a purpose. So what is this concept of Industry 4.0? I'll start from here. Any one of you would like to add something on Industry 4.0? What does Industry 4.0 mean to you? Or it's for the very first time you're hearing this word. Industry 4.0, basically the full form is Industrial Revolution 4. We are right now Industrial Revolution 4, where everything is driven by some kind of communication, which is the internet. So what is the belief system of each one of us to understand how IPR can be fortified for your own well-being, and being you should know about what is IPR? Because once you're out of college, there are only two aspects where people will venture out. One is starting your own business model or working for someone else. So when you work for someone else, you're going to sign some kind of contract. And remember, in that contract, there would be a clause which will talk about intellectual property rights. And intellectual property rights is all about whatever is being created that is being protected, so that you can reap the benefits. Because once you start with a business model, or once you start working for someone, there's a vision and a mission statement of that business, and there's a value proposition. So what happens is, once a business is started, started in any domain whatsoever, say for example, somebody is an internet entrepreneur. So that person or that business model will have some kind of vision and mission and a value proposition. So any business model in India or any brand, you can write about that in the chat box again. Is something clicking your mind right now when you talk about Made in India, like it is Made in India tagline. Any business in India which is Indian oriented, can you name few brands which you think is Indian and started by Indian entrepreneurs, or any company for which you would like to work? Do you have something in your mind? You can write it again there, and from there we will take on to the next slide. So what is very important here is, since 2020 and years to come, you are going to see a very different scenario as how the hiring process will also take place. If you are reading about it, it is going to be a total game changer, because everybody wants to hire a person who has that entrepreneurial gene in that person, so that the work or the role play assigned to that person can be taken to the next level of understanding. So how many of you have heard about Paytm? I think when we talk about the digital economy in India, somehow or the other, the word Paytm resonates with each one of us, and especially in the youngster pool, each one of us is using Paytm in some aspect or the other. So Paytm is one of the brands which was started by an Indian entrepreneur and that is doing quite well. What is important here is, as I said, you have to identify your own role play in terms of whether you want to be an entrepreneur or whether you want to be someone who wants to work with someone, or you have a family business, you want to take that legacy to the next level. So those are the questions I think you might be trying to answer right now. Invest in yourself. So as I said, intellectual property rights is all about creating something. And once you create something, you protect it through various means so that you are able to enjoy and reap the benefits in terms of your consumers are able to identify your product or service, or you are packaging your services into a product, maybe a software, or you are amalgamating blockchain, artificial intelligence, IoT, and then coming up with a new business model. I think this is a very good time to work in a holistic manner whereby new business models are coming in place. People are investing in understanding their own connect. And once you understand your own potential, you know where you want to work, you know what you want to do in life. So a very important aspect is how you invest in yourself and understand the IPRs in a manner so that it is a win-win situation for each of your connects, including yourself. So this is a very interesting slide whereby this slide has a lot of, pictorial representation. So any of the pictorial representation, is it resonating with you? If it is, there's some kind of resonance, you can write in the chat box again, like, okay, this is something I'm able to resonate with. Like say, for example, the bulb is basically, it denotes a $1 billion idea or a $1 trillion economy idea. Then there's another one which is talking about the latitude and the longitude where the GPRS or the GPS location is identified. If you see even the Indian government right now is coming up with a lot of mobile applications whereby it is stating that they take your location and the location is identified when your GPR is activated or Bluetooth is activated. So there are different technologies whereby each business model right now is trying to be a part or connect the dots and develop something whereby the parameters, say for example, the ventilator example, we will take here. So in a ventilating machine, a number of parameters are being recorded. So those parameters are then being transferred back to a mobile application. And then there's a threshold there where if the threshold is crossed, then the data matrix is informed to the professional. And here the professional can be a medical professional also. So your role play is going to be the three magical doors. And what are the three magical doors in terms of IPR we'll be discussing now? So the very first thing and the very important factor, I think, if you have been reading the newspapers and if you understand a little bit of economics, intellectual property rights is very, very important. And the first intellectual property right, or the right which we are going to talk about, is about patents. So patents is basically any technology which is novel. First of all, IPR rights are given to a technology or to a business model in terms of branding, which we'll be discussing in coming slides. So patents is basically an ideation stage, which is given a thought process, and then you have a product. It can be a process patent, it can be an apparatus patent, it can be a handheld device. So handheld device is basically a device which you can hold in the hand and it is performing some kind of function. So that is a patent. And here I have some examples, and especially I have taken some examples from 3D printing itself, so that you have a better idea of what all can come under the umbrella of a patent. So this is a very interesting example whereby this is an international application. And if you see, this is an Israeli company which filed the application in 2019 and it was published in 2020. The application title is three-dimensional object printing method. So 3D is all about printing, and 3D printing can be utilized in multiple ways. Let's look at this video. It will give you more details.
Hi, Preeti, this video is not playing, I think.
What happened?
This video is not playing.
I played it at my end.
Yeah, but here I think it didn't appear. It is just still.
Still? Okay. So how to share this one?
Maybe you can initially cover your presentation, then we will see in the end.
Okay, fine, we can do that. Okay. Okay, fine. So this video, we will replay it in the end again. So basically, this is a technology whereby, as the source is here, and maybe I'll share this PPT also. So it's super fast 3D printing technology for business success. So a lot of applications, I think around about, there are 10,000 plus applications which have been filed as international patents to protect the prototyping process. So this is the website of this company, which the company which I talked about in the previous slide. And this is the application, or I would say the details of the application, how a patent is drafted, and it is, if you see the picture here, so in the 3D prototyping here, they have this solidifying module. Yes. So it's a 3D object material solidifying module, which is configured wherein at least a portion of the material forming at least a layer of the 3D object and a control computer. So the point here is a technology where even a slight variation is there, it can be protected by way of filing patents. And India is signatory to multiple treaties. The process can be initiated from India, and then one can file an international patent and enter multiple countries. More than 140 countries one can enter to protect the innovations in multiple countries. So one very important aspect of any intellectual property right is the IPR right is jurisdiction specific. What does that mean? It means, say for example, you have protected your invention. So invention, when idea is given the form of invention and then you file a patent application, that is known as a patent. So the invention, if it is protected in India and it is not protected in US, so anybody in US can use that application without giving any royalty. Similarly, if invention, say for example, this invention of 3D prototyping has been filed in Israel and then an international patent has been filed, if they don't enter India or if they don't file their patent application in India, one is free to use the application without giving any royalty. However, if the patent is filed in India and the patent is granted in India, so the tenure of a patent application is 20 years from the date of first filing. Say for example, somebody filed an application on 26th December 2019. So within 12 months, 26th December 2020, you have to enter into multiple countries or you need to file an international application. So the protection date will start from 2019 plus 20 years. So that's the age of a patent. So in this particular application, what they try to protect is also the method of doing it. Say for example, I think since all of you are coming from 3D printing background, or most of you are from that background, assuming that. So you will resonate with the flow chart here. So your 3D object information is received from a CAD system. Then the analysis is done. Now there's a decision box. And what that decision box is doing is decide on object segments to be manufactured with different layer width or height. So basically, in this application, or the application is trying to claim, or the inventive part is to manufacture with different layer width or height and manufacture the 3D object according to the analysis performed. And that's the simple flowchart which they are trying to claim in this particular application. So that is what patent is all about. If you have any other question regarding patents, we can take that once the presentation is over. The second very important IPR right is trademark. Trademark again is the trade name of any business model, or the trade name can be yourself also. Like say for example, Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar, since he is a celebrity in himself and everybody knows him, so even he has got his signature trademark, and that signature is being utilized in different merchandise and different business models are being developed around it. So that is one type of trademark. Then there is something called as goods and something called as services. As I said, businesses are of two types. Either you are in the manufacturing sector, either you are in the service sector. So you need to see, especially in the current era whereby most of the businesses, even if you are manufacturing, you are servicing your customers through the online media. So once you are servicing the customers through the online media, you might need to file a trademark in multiple classes, and not only one class would be applicable, there would be multiple classes. Say for example, in the sector of clothing, or if I talk about the mask right now, so there are particular sections in the trademark law which states that this class is applicable for the headgear. And there's another section, or I would say the class is there, whereby the trademark is basically advertising, marketing to the online media. So that's a different class altogether. So that is what trademark is all about. Generally, what happens in the Indian ecosystem, there's always a confusion with the brand name. Brand name is a brand, maybe it's a logo, or maybe it's a tagline. And that is different from a patent. Patent is basically for invention, which we already talked about. And trademark is basically the trade which the organization or the entity is trying to do, and through which your consumers are going to identify your business model. Because many a times, say for example, I think if you talk about the online business models or the offline business models, in the online business models, we have food delivery like Swiggy, we have Zomato, and there are a couple of other ventures also. However, what is important here is how many of you know the owner of Zomato, or how many of you even know the owner of Swiggy. So nobody is interested in knowing the owner. People are interested in the business model. People are interested in the output or the service or the product which that company is trying to provide. So that is what trademark is all about. So here, Swiggy is a trademark. Paytm is a trademark. Zomato is a trademark. And I think from the very beginning, I think Maggie is a household brand, and it attracts attention and adds excitement. Now, what happens when we talk about branding? Branding is all about how your consumers are able to relate to yourself. Many a times, your name itself can be a brand. Like if we talk about in the fitness sector right now, Shilpa Shetty is a brand, and she is coming up with a mobile application. So how consumers are able to relate to you and why your consumers are going to purchase your product or service is the question you need to answer. So brand name is all about to attract the attention and add excitement in the mind of the customer. And the customer should be able to resonate with your brand. So when we talk about Maggie, the first thing which comes in our mind is the tagline, the 2-minute tagline, ki Maggie 2 minutes mein ban jata hai. Many a times, till date, I don't know how Maggie is prepared in 2 minutes, but that's what the tagline they have been utilizing. So trademark is all to do with the name. So here if you see Maggie, which is in a color format. So the color yellow and red resonates with Maggie. Same goes for McDonald's also. If you see, the color combination is almost the same. And then this is a logo. How that logo is resonating with the customer, if the customer is able to recognize his or her product when it is on the market shelf. Take for example, you go to a market shelf and it is there on the market shelf and you are able to recognize it, then the brand name becomes a household brand. Another very important household brand in India is Britannia right now, and especially in this lockdown time, if you see the shares value of Britannia, it is increasing. So the share market size of each share of Britannia is increasing right now, and brand name is very, very important. Many a times it becomes more important than a patent, because in a patent, there has to be an invention. Then only you get a patent receipt from the, or I would say the patent grant certificate, because it's a big, it's a long process and it has a multi-step process. Whereas the trademark is all to do about if you understand your brand, and if you're able to come out with a different logo design, and your consumers are able to identify that brand, and it is different. I think the very important factor is it has to be different and it has to be unique, so that you are able to get your customers. So that's the question you need to answer even as an entrepreneur when you start with a company. Why you want to start with a company with a particular brand? If you're able to answer that question, then I think you're good to go or understand entrepreneurship in a better manner. So, as I said, trademark is all about how you market yourself, how you are marketing in terms of product and the service. I have few more examples which I would be discussing. So the next very important IPR right is copyright. So copyright is all to do with, say for example, you have a software, and the coding of the software is proprietary in nature. It's not an open source software, or you're not taking the code from an open code or GitHub. So in that case, if it is proprietary in nature, you can always file for a copyright application. Then copyright is very, very important for literary work. It is very important for people who are coming up with new lyrics. So you need to get your copyright protected. The copyright law is quite stringent in India, and IPR rights per se is becoming very, very important, because wherever there is intellectual property rights, there would be some kind of contract in place. And as I said, once you are, like right now you are a student, once you are out of college, you would be joining some organization, or you would be starting your own startup. So if you're joining any organization, you would be signing some kind of contract, and there would be a clause whereby it would state any intellectual property right which is being developed during the tenure of your work with them, that would be owned by the company itself, and you're agreeing to it. And if you're agreeing to it and you're signing on that contract, so whatever IPR or whatever IP is created, that is IP stands for intellectual property, so whatever is created would be owned by the owner of the contract. So it's a contract can be two-party, tri-party, that depends upon the situation. So if we talk about the copyright office, there's only one corporate office in India, and that is based in Delhi, in Dwarka right now. So yes, copyright can be filed for literary work, for codes, source codes which are proprietary in nature. So you get a certificate again for each of the IPR rights. Once it is registered, you get a certification, and with that certificate, that becomes your asset. Asset in terms of just like real estate, IPR is also an asset, and it is very much tangible when you are earning wealth from it. If money is the output, then it becomes very much tangible in nature. Now, very important thing is, as I said, IPR is all to do with creativity. So, creativity is whatever is coming into your mind, and if you think it is protection worthy, you protect it. Many a times I would say each one of us on a daily basis, we have so many ideas to solve so many problems. It's only a matter of few people coming together to solve a question, or I would say to solve a purpose. Right now, if we talk about in the current ecosystem, and there's another right which is very, very important, whereby I think different business models can be a part of this IPR itself. So protecting your creativity is very important. Copyright matters, yes. I think if you have created something and you understand the asset creation model, or if you understand that, okay, this is something you really think is protection worthy, go for some kind of IP, right? It adds value to your own CV also. Say, for example, in your current capacity, if you're building something or you have built a innovation in terms of maybe a product, process, or any other kind of stuff which can be protected under patents, go for filing a patent application, add it to your CV, that adds value. As I said, the entrepreneurs or the startups also, they're looking for people, or they would hire people who understand the IP rights, because if you see the top 7 companies in the global arena, whether it's Apple, whether it's Amazon, whether it's Microsoft, they all are earning through the asset-light model in terms of they have a lot of intellectual property rights in terms of patents, trademarks, copyrights, industrial designs, which we'll be talking about in coming slides. So most of the assets or the evaluation of the company is done in terms of what kind of intellectual property rights they have, who are the consumers, how consumers are resonating with the brand. And in India, a very good example can be Jio Reliance. Then another very good example can be Airtel. So these are the two main brands with which the foreign companies are collaborating. We have seen or we have read about the collaboration between Facebook and Reliance Jio. Again, Amazon is investing with Bharti Airtel. Walmart somehow is trying to get a pie of India, because one has to understand in terms of the youth, the Indian youth, that's the maximum population if you talk on a global basis. Then the other very important aspect is we are a population of 1.37 billion people. I think I read somewhere it is now being talked about we are crossing 1.4 billion also, or it will be in months or years to come. So the chunk of the data, the big data which we talk about, or the resonance of the different business models would be in the term of big data. And that big data is coming, a huge big data is coming from India. So that is why IP rights become more important in months and years to come, especially in the Indian ecosystem. Now, this is a very interesting IPR right, that is geographical indication. Why I say it's very interesting in the current situation, if we understand India, though India is, if we see it on a world map, it's a small chunk of land on the world map. However, if we understand the ecosystem in terms of people living in a particular place are totally different from people living 100 kilometers from that particular place. Why I say so? Geographical indication itself means the geography of that place indicates the origin of the manufacturing good or services. So what is geographical indication all about? So geographical indication refers to indication which identifies goods as agriculture, say for example, Darjeeling tea. It means if somebody is selling Darjeeling tea, it has to be from Darjeeling. It cannot be a tea grown in some other part. Then natural or manufactured goods, including handicraft. I think if somebody has gone to Pragati Maidan in recent years, or I think in Greater Noida, you also have these places where a lot of handicraft exhibitions are held. You will see Madhubani art. Then there are so many other handicrafts and textiles which come from a particular area. Only people in that particular area are the skilled artisans who are doing that kind of art. And that art is from like maybe, you know, coming 500 years ago. However, that art is not dying. So that is what geographical indication is all about. Now, government is taking a lot of proactive approach so that they can protect that art. So basically, geographical indication is the origin. Origin is mentioned when we talk about, say for example, Kashmiri saffron. So Kashmiri saffron means the saffron is grown in Jammu and Kashmir. So that's how the origin is defined. So in a given quality, it has a reputation, and this again can be protected through the filing of geographical indication application. So in the case of manufactured goods, say for example the handicrafts, the production or the processing takes place in a particular territory, region or locality. So territory can be like, say for example, Jammu Kashmir, something is happening in Jharkhand, something is happening in a local tribe whereby they are doing some kind of art form which is protected through geographical indication. And in the recent months, what has been happening is these geographical indications, especially the handicrafts, these are being done in the form of masks, and then it is being sold off so that those art forms still remain very much alive, because the new generation is not doing that kind of work. And since the new generation is not doing that kind of work, that art is dying. So one has to protect the different art forms in India, and that is how geographical indication comes into play. So what happens in this, as I said, the government of India is actually investing a lot in even advertising about geographical indication. And in the recent address, our Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji emphasized the need of being more vocal about local products to revive the economy. So having said that, the GI tag, I think we understand, or I would say currently we all are living in a world where we are using hashtags. You know, we have hashtags for everything. Even on Instagram, if you upload a picture, we have a hashtag pick of the day, and there are different hashtags. So when anything which is registered under a GI, DITP has come up with this tag which talks about, which is colored, which is tricolor, and it has a tagline which says, "Invaluable treasures of incredible India, Atulya Bharat ki Amulya Nidhi." So this tag can be used, and only people who are part of this ecosystem can use it and sell it off. And that's how businesses can be run in terms in the new economy. Like if you say you take up the initiative of going to nearby places and seeing what people are doing in terms of the artisans. So I have one very good example here. As we discussed about the tagline, that it represents the spirit of geographical indication of India and will assist in effective branding and promotion of GI. It will also help in engaging more people on the subject of GI and create awareness about the benefit of a GI tag. So till now, according to the government website, the source is here, you can also go there, 370 applications have been registered under GI in India. And the 370 application, this is the latest data of April 2020. It's in a handicraft which comes from Jharkhand. And I have procured some of the pictures. So this is basically the handicraft of Jharkhand, which is protected as GI. And in many of the cases, now what they are doing, as I suggested, or as I said, many of the business models are, they are using the GIs on the face mask rather than just a maybe, you know, a quote, not a quotation. Yes, some companies or the established companies, they're using quotations, but the new business models are being developed whereby they are using the GI. So the GI is promoted and the product also gets some kind of market traction right now. So the handicraft of Jharkhand, the story of the discovery of the painting and getting them on the pan, this was very interesting. This happens in a village in a village called Hazira Bagh, within a 50 kilometer radius, and there are particular these handicrafts. They actually depict the decoration of marriage chambers, and it is a harvest painting on the mud houses, repairing it after the rain. So what is happening is there are tribes all over India. If you talk about the handicrafts, and definitely there are states, every state has some kind of geographical indication. So maybe the people who want to be entrepreneurs, they can look at this data sheet, or they can just understand what's very unique in their hometown, and that becomes a geographical indication. So government is promoting a lot. Just imagine, in a country of 1.4 billion people, we just have 370 registrations till date, which I think is a very low number as compared to the kind of creativity which is there in India. Now, the next important, I would say, the intellectual property right is industrial design. And I think industrial design is very much applicable to 3D printing industry, because industrial design is all to do with the aesthetic look or the ornamental look of the, I would say, the model. And if, say, for even a pump, even a water pump, if it has a different aesthetic look, that can be protected under industrial design. And industrial design registration is an effective measure to even create a good number of assets. So can anyone recognize this industrial design, or any idea, if somebody is able to recognize this industrial design, that person can write it in the chat box. And basically, as I said, industrial design is all to do with the appearance. So any kind of innovation or any kind of invention which goes into the method of preparing it, or it's the overall apparatus device that is protected by patent, the look and the feel of the product or the 3D or the 2D patent, that comes under industrial design. So basically, this design is from Maserati. So though it looks like a Trishul of Shivji, Maserati has this industrial design with them, and it's their logo brand. BMW has its own way of logo. So those are aspects are also part of industrial design. Now, in the clothing sector, again, companies like Biba, they find a lot of application in industrial design, and that's how they create their portfolio of industrial design. So industrial designs is how something looks. Even a Coke bottle, the way the designing is done, that is part of industrial design. So for any intellectual property rights, whether we talked about patents, trademarks, copyrights, geographical indication, industrial design, they should be new and original. That means something which hasn't been developed till date. And why it is very important that it's new and original? Because when that product or the process goes into the market, the consumer should be able to differentiate, and they should be able to buy the best quality products or best services from the market. And in this case also, industrial design should not be published in any other country. It should not be contrary to the public order or morality. So now we'll talk a little bit about entrepreneurship. Dr. Shiv told me to talk a little bit about startups, entrepreneurship. What does it take to be an entrepreneur? I think to be an entrepreneur, it's a complete package. And many a times, what you will see in the current trend also, entrepreneurship is being included in the course material of different colleges in India and globally. So everything starts with the idea, ideation stage. We all have ideas. There are only few people who really execute very simple ideas, and the execution is so good that they are able to capture a pie of the market. and the pie of the market can be big as you want if you are able to collaborate with the right players and if you have the best of the people on your team, so that it's a win-win for everyone. So entrepreneurship also, it's all about ideation. What kind of idea you have, how you want to start it. The best thing right now in the current scheme of things is when we talk about ideation, it's all to do with how innovative you are with the business model, what problem are you trying to solve, and the easiest way to go ahead, in my viewpoint, would be to have some kind of online presence, because when you buy a domain name and you prepare something, because there are so many tools like WordPress, you have some websites which provide you all the modules which are required to prepare a website also. So those are there on a fingertip, and just by tapping 2-3 are able to prepare something. That's what ideation stage is all about, rather than just scribbling on paper. Have your own asset. The easiest way, even for the ideation stage, is right now, if I talk about the people who really are looking forward to be a part of a bigger organization or start the organization, is being part of something which is already very much tested. And a very good platform right now is LinkedIn. And I think if you guys are not on LinkedIn, or you folks are not on LinkedIn, you should have a LinkedIn profile. You should see, or there's always a search bar where you can search about the topic of interest, read about those topics, give your own viewpoint. Having a viewpoint is very important. It's not important if the viewpoint is right or wrong. If you resonate with that viewpoint, go ahead, write about it, discuss it in the open forums. Be very vocal. As you are seeing in the current era, local pe vocal, vocal pe local concept is going. So vocal is also very important in terms of whatever, I would say, the ethics, the code of ethics, or whatever ideas or whatever your understanding is, share it with people. The more knowledge you share with people, the more you gain at the end of the day. Now, talking about the launch pad. So SWOT analysis is very important. SWOT analysis basically to do with the strength. When I see SWOT analysis, I only focus on SNO. So basically, SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. However, if you are able to work on that parameter of strength and opportunities, because the opportunities, when put in the right format, that becomes your strength. So how you can bring your opportunities, or how you can identify the opportunities in the current market era, that would be and then you pick your path whereby you can just rise the way you want to rise. And that's what SWOT analysis is all about. Whether you require some kind of funding, however, I would suggest have your own business model, and at least the ideation stage should be crossed, so that even when you are talking to the investors, they see you as a serious entrepreneur, and that is the time they invest in you. Otherwise, nobody is going to invest any money in any kind of startup. Think outside. Think out of the box. I think in the current times, I believe each human is a genius human being. It's only how you activate your IC. IC is basically that gene or the DNA which enables your capacity to be a better human being, and better being your own better version, you become a genius in the end. So basically, as I said, ideation stage, when you talk about a business model, when you talk about a product, identify that ideation stage. You might like to file a trademark, because branding is very important. How consumers are going to perceive your brand or your business model, maybe see what kind of intellectual property right protection you need at that point of time. Filing patents is a good idea because you can always utilize the tag of patent pending tag as a marketing tool. And there are different platforms, not only in India, but on a global level, where mentoring is provided. You can pitch in your ideas with a business model. Okay, so we have some questions. Probably I'll just take those questions once we are done with the presentation. This question is from Alam. I'll take your question. Just let me just finish this presentation and then we'll take your question. So funding. Now the billion or trillion dollar question is, how do you write your own success story? I think success is something which is a lifelong journey. Success cannot be defined where you say, I'm successful today, because once you are in that zone, that is going to be a lifelong journey. You are going to pivot. In terms of even as a business owner, like today I'm a business owner, but I have to pivot my business model right now in the current dynamics of the market. So pivoting is very important because the more you pivot, the better the chances to survive in any given circumstance. And the very simple example I would say is biomimicry. Biomimicry is a science whereby we learn a lot from observing nature. I think in the current time, each one of us is learning a lot from the nature, or I would say the mother nature itself. If you understand any kind of tree, maybe a people tree, the root itself is like, you know, it's so grounded. The roots are in multiple formats and there are multiple branches out of that root. There are sub-branches. So that is what business is all about. Never put all your eggs in one basket. You need to have three, four business revenue models so that you are able to survive in the long run. For the starting, obviously, you are trying to figure out what is going to work for you, what is not going to work for you. Just concentrate on the fact that what you are good at. Because what at the end of the day, your USP, or I'll be talking about some of the magical beings right now. So in the current time, only people who understand those concepts of how you are going to survive or how you are going to do better will lead you to understand any business in a better manner. So the action plan is very simple for any business model, whether you are a one-upper or you want to be an entrepreneur or you would be sitting for some kind of interview. Right now, and most of the interviews are going to right now happen through, you know, Zoom or some other kind of interface whereby you'll be talking via a UI is user interface again. So how you imbibe and emulate in the current scheme of things, how visionary you are with your own vision is very, very important, because presentation is the best communication tool. And in my practice of so many years right now, what I have seen, the dilemma here is the communication. Many a times what happens is when two people talk, they communicate something, A communicates something to B communicates something to C. But by the time the person is executing, the communication is something else. So you need to understand and gather the right information notes, so that you are able to communicate with your peers well, which is very, very important, because when you are part of an ecosystem, you have to work as a team. And I think if you are playing sports, if some of you have been playing some kind of sports, you understand being a team player is very, very important. So innovation is all about to solve the current issues. The video which I would be sharing about the 3D printing also, they were talking about cost. Cost is a big factor. I think right now, each one of us will appreciate the fact that the way the real estate or the way the offices were utilized before, I would say till 2019, the whole dynamics is going to change since 2020. I think most of the people still are working from home because of the current given scenario. So how innovative one can be to solve the current problems, that's where innovation comes into play. And be very innovative in your thought process also. Innovation doesn't mean that if you have an idea, you have to file a patent application, otherwise, you know, somebody is going to copy your idea. Don't get into that FOMO that, you know, somebody will copy. What is very important is the execution, because by the time you put your energy and time getting these things, in a fast, speedy manner, somebody else is going to execute it. So that is also one aspect one should keep in mind. Okay, so I will be giving you some secret beans, and these have been my favorite beans which I have been sharing with people globally in my online workshop. So it's a game time. You need to write a 4-letter word to define yourself, and you can write in the chat box just to see how you people resonate with a 4-letter word, because many a times you are going to get very different questions right now, even in your interviews. So just think of a 4-letter word with which you are able to resonate yourself, and you can write in the chat box right now. Or if you're not comfortable writing it, you can write in your copy and just keep it with you so that you can think over it and ponder over it after this presentation. So I'll give you maybe a minute or so. So I would be sharing my idea of the 4-letter word, the word with which I resonate a lot, because what happens is on a daily basis as an entrepreneur, because this section of the presentation is all about entrepreneurship. I think in entrepreneurship, nobody is giving us bonuses. We create bonuses. We are creating day in and day out. So what happens is, it's a good role play to play. Entrepreneurship comes with a lot of advantage also, because you are responsible to take all the decisions, and the decisions which you take depends on a lot of factors. So you have to, I would rather say, you have to take the right decision so that you are able to survive in this game called business. Because again, business, if you understand business, we might be playing Monopoly in our childhood. So these are the different things which you can resonate and understand what the world of business is all about. Okay, so my 4-letter word for today is Jedi. I believe in the current times, there are two movies which were released in last year of 2019 and early 2021, the Jumanji and the Star Wars. So it's most of you have seen Star Wars, you will understand that movie that resonates with the youth of us. I think if we are able to understand what is a Jedi and how you really want to perform or outperform your own capabilities, I think it's very, very important. So this is a quote by Steve Jobs. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life. I think once your student life is over, then it's your work life. And the only way to live a very fruitful life is to do great work. Be good in what you do, whatever you do. And when you love what you do, you keep looking and you don't settle. And that's what matters in life. Because that's when you are creating something new, you are created with your own thought process. So there's another secret bean I would like to talk about, and this is a very important concept, the hashtag PC. Maybe from today onwards, you can actually look out for the words where there are two words in consecutive, the two words which talk about something and which relate to the hashtag PC. Now, which side of the timeline you are? You can either be on the right side or you can be on the left side of PC. So, one is content creation. Now, what is this concept of content creation. I think as entrepreneurs or as people who create something, they always want to be on the side of content creation. Because once you start, or I would say, or you resonate, or you train your mind to be a content creator, you are creating something day in, day out. You see right now, a lot of news platforms are there. There are a lot of applications which just pop up on a daily basis, and they're not real. So there's so much of content in the online media. You don't know what is the real content and what is the content which is being forwarded just to seek your attention. So being a content creator will fetch you, or it will make you a better entrepreneur. And especially even if you are working for any organization also, if you are on the part of content creation, you will understand intellectual property rights in a better fashion, because intellectual property rights is all about creating something. And being creative and being on the part of content creation side, it will facilitate and it will make you understand things in a very different manner. This is something, again, nobody is teaching right now. This is something you have to learn over the years. And this is one of my learnings in past few years, that it is better to be a content creator or be on the side of content creation. Because then you know what kind of data you want to read, what kind of data you just don't want to even see. Because what is coming in newspapers is not something where everything is true. It is how you imbibe it. What are the pointers from that particular article? Maybe an article is a half-page article. However, you just imbibe maybe 3-4 lines, because that are important. And data is very important. You know, everybody's talking about big data, how big data-based applications can be utilized. You might be reading about data privacy issues. Our government is promoting a lot of these aspects. So I think once you come online, you have to be very careful about this hashtag CC, whether you are a content creator or not. So another very important aspect of entrepreneurship is working at your intellectual capacity. Like people talk about, you know, work hard, it's hard work only pays. Pays or plays. I would say what is important here is the intellectual capacity of thinking in the right direction and using these tools which are easily available, because that is going to do the optimization. See, each one of us are given with that timeline of 24 hours. And in those 24 hours, many people do so many things, and many people are just able to perform 3 or 4 activities. So how you optimize your other work resources gives you time to read, gives you time to ponder, gives you time to create something new. And as I said, you come on the side of... Secret being 8. Now, as I said, when we talk about CC, there are only 2 aspects. Either you are a content creator or you are a content consumer. Most of the people who are online right now, maybe I think due to lockdown, the percentage has increased. More people are online for the very first time, or they have to be online, they like it or not. And that percentage is coming around somewhere between 35% to 40%. So most of you are content consumers. So what happens in content consumers is when you consume something, what happens? You digest it. It's just like simple biology. So even the content which is shown to you, you are consuming it, and then your thinking process starts in that direction. So getting the thinking process in the positive direction is very important. And the easiest way to understand the SWOT analysis, which I talked about in my previous slide also, working on your strengths, is being a content creator. Now, it's up to you on which side of the line you want to be. If you don't realize it today, maybe you'll realize it, you know, 3 months from now, 6 months from now, years from now. However, what I would suggest, or from my experience, you should be on the side of content creator, so that you are able to understand the data matrix in a better format, and you are able to do wonders. I think at the end of the day, we all want to live a wonderful life and a fruitful life, you know, wonderful, fruitful life. And for that, one has to understand IPR in the true sense. IPR doesn't mean you have to protect everything. IPR means how you understand, how you implement in your daily life. Maybe, you know, many a times we file patent applications. So in patent applications, as I said, there's a process whereby you can secure a date for your patent application, and within 12 months, you have to file a complete application. Say, for example, you are part of something called as new product development, or you're doing some kind of research. In that case, you file a provision patent application, and then you do the re-engineering. Re-engineering is all about, since the innovation has to be new, novel, in that case, in re-engineering, we as patent specialists, we research a lot of international databases to come up with the ideas which being floated to us at the first instance itself. And then the re-engineering starts, and then the complete application shapes up. So it's basically how a patent specialist is able to write it, being a content creator, and present it in a manner which is very novel in nature. So that's what patent application is all about. Now, if you see in the current ecosystem, and especially in last 3 months, all the shops, like if you talk about shops, I think Amazon is a shop, then Facebook is a shop right now. Shop means the organization, the entity which is holding a lot of intellectual property rights. And intellectual property rights can also be measured in the big data. The number of consumers which you have is your intellectual property. Now, why the sharks and the fishes are, they are coming together in a collaborative approach is very simple, to pool the resources. I think pooling of resources is very, very important. Even the startups, maybe one startup has good coders. The other startups have branding people. So working in a win-win approach is the only way to even launch your product in a fast, speedy manner. So one has to work in synchronicity, and intellectual property is all to do with a theory which is being applied by few organizations, but not all. The way I see it, in coming days or in coming years, organizations are also going to share the revenue pattern with the inventors, because neither of them can work in alone in terms of, if say for example, some companies providing you all the resources. However, there's nobody to work on it. So no intellectual property would be invented, or no intellectual property would be generated. So how the royalty which is being generated can be shared with the maximum pie, in terms of right now, if we understand the business community, only 1% of the whole population globally owns the wealth. Why is it so? Because whatever IPR is coming, the royalty or the contracts are drafted in a manner that the owners of the, maybe the stakeholders are getting the stake. What about the inventors? I think inventors also play a very important role, because they are the people who are actually inventing. So sharing the piece of the pie with the inventors also is a good way of giving back to the community, and the inventors can always reinvest and do whatever they want to do with that. Then a very important topic which I thought you guys should know about is CL. CL stands for compulsory licensing in India. So in the current time also, if somebody is coming up with a vaccine, and obviously if one organization, or I would say a pharmaceutical company, has invented a vaccine, so in that case, the royalty has to be redistributed. And in the Indian patent law, there is a section which talks about compulsory licensing, whereby if the company doesn't agree to give a license, one can always file for compulsory licensing, because it should be affordable to the masses. The whole idea of intellectual property rights protection is to share the IP generated or the creativity generated for the benefit of the mankind. And that is the reason why government is even giving you those certificates, and government is backing you up in that regard. So it's always good to share the resources, and good revenues definitely are going to increase the GDP. And as I already suggested, that a lot of work is being done in GI. GI is geographical indications. And just imagine, there are only 70 applications which are registered under GI. There's so much of GI, I think, everywhere. You know, I think there are many places which are very rich sources of Ayurveda, handicraft. Just by observing, you will understand this is very unique to this place. So those aspects can be protected in GI, and then people like you and me can be part of those organizations and bring those handicrafts or those articles of manufacture in the online world, sell it and share it with the world, and that's how the export is going to be more, and that's how the GDP is going to be more, because GDP is all to do with supply and demand. So we just need to create that supply chain rather than the demand, I think, because globally, if you talk to people who are outside India, they are very much fascinated by Indian yoga, they are fascinated by the Indian spices. So the demand is there, but the supply is not there. So I think that is one aspect you people can see into, because very, very simple business models can be a win-win for everyone, because you will not only be facilitating the artisans or the people in the local areas with a livelihood, you would be showcasing what India has in store for the world to see. Because there are a lot of aspects till now has not seen the light in the online world, and that is where each one of us can play a very important role. So the outcome right now, if you see, the government is emphasizing on a lot of aspects, and innovation hubs per se are being opened up in colleges, so that like utter incubation, and there are different mission projects under which innovation hubs are being started, so that the talent can be nurtured from day one. If you are in first year, you are grilled from day one to understand how to work in a culture of public sector or private sector, perhaps, because now gone are those days where you get up even a public job and you retire. I think in this time and the days and months which we are seeing, I think a lot is going to change. It's mainly going to be the talent is going to rule the charts, otherwise people are going to perish in terms of the talent and the skill set. So you need to have those required skill sets from the very beginning, and Innovation Hub is a good way to initiate this facilitation. So entrepreneurship, I think it's a ship, it's a lifelong journey. You have to marry your business. I think that's the only best way to put it forward in one liner, if you ask me. You have to marry what you do in terms of, because that's the most time of your life you're going to spend with, or maybe, you know, thinking about what to write next, being creative, thinking about whom to talk, thinking about how to increase the sales. So what are the four main aspects which are very, very important for an entrepreneur to flourish in any given circumstances? Is you have to be hopeful that your magical door is going to open. I think that is very, very, very important, because once you are hopeful, you start getting those ideas, and you have to approach the world called life with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of energy. You have to be grateful for everything which you are doing. I think since your childhood till whatever format you are in right now, I think you have to be really grateful about you know, getting the best of the resources available doing these workshops. I think I saw the content of this workshop and I was really impressed. I think there's so much to learn from the workshop itself. So I think this has been a very good learning for you guys, and be authentic. I think entrepreneurship is all about being yourself, because if you are thinking of even like businesses are running two ways, either you will be self-funded for life, or you would like to be funded by someone, or I would say the third magical door would be if you're so good, people will start approaching you and they will like to be part of your venture. So the more authentic you are, the more different you are, because each human being is very different. And as I already talked about in my previous slide, that you have to be your own brand, because once you are your own brand, you are able to sell anything. And the best example can be your Sachin Tendulkar. I think if he signs off on a shirt, also you will purchase it for 1,000 rupees. So that's how important the brand is. Branding can be of many types. We already talked about it. Experience. I think it's always good to ask questions, because just understand this time is never going to come back. Experience teaches you the real meaning of even executing any task at hand. Many a times, you know, I remember in my childhood, we used to ask our teachers or our peers. There are many people who were in the class itself. There are few people who will never talk. There are few people who will ask too many questions. And there are few people who balance out, you know, question and answer now. I think asking questions, or I would say asking the right questions, is very important, because you understand a lot of pointers from that. And then you decide whether you want to go ahead from there or not. Because at any given point of time, there's a flowchart going in our brain also. Because determination points are so many at any given stance. Say, for example, after this workshop, before just going to sleep, if you understand how many times you are making those small, small decisions, you will be surprised to see like half the time you are just making decisions. Because where to have lunch or not, where to drink water or not. So these are also decisions which you are making. So experience counts a lot, and ask the right questions. Because once you're out of the college, then it's up to you how you want to see life. And another thing is, there's a QR code here. You can scan the QR code. You can connect with me on LinkedIn. I'm quite active on LinkedIn. And if you don't have profiles on LinkedIn, it's a good time to have a profile there and start talking about things which you really resonate with. What are your interests in terms of how you see yourself 6 months from now, 1 year from now? If you start writing about it, you will get better clarity as to what you want to do in life. So you will be seeing a lot of courses which are being organized in the online world is about design thinking. And as I said, you have the right to activate your IT. IT or design thinking are working synchronicity. That means design thinking is basically to be your own architecture of things you really want to do. And design thinking capacity can be activated once you become or you are part of the CC, which is content creator. Because once you are in the creator mode, you are always doing design thinking in whatever endeavors you are taking. Maybe, you know, if you're even cooking, for example, or you are doing a 3D printing, you know, if you are coming up with an invention, which is actually, you're talking about models. I shared one video and I would be resharing again so that you have better clarity over it, how CAD people can be innovative enough and they can build something which is very meaningful to everyone. So, just a bit about myself, because after design thinking, I thought it's good to talk about yourself also, because then you're talking about your experience. I'm an intellectual property lawyer. I did my graduation from Delhi University in Applied Science Honors. Then I ventured out in doing another technology course in biotech, and in the final year, I cleared the patent agent exam conducted by Ministry of Commerce way back in 2006. Then along with my work, I finished my law, and over the years, I have branded myself as innovation coach because I believe I'm able to facilitate that intellectual capacity gene. And since I am also a part of a group of mediators where we do commercial mediation, so mediation is all about to get the best outcome for both the parties. So I think coaching becomes very much important. And so I have self-branded myself as the innovation coach. And the only puzzle I'm trying to solve right now is to achieve the 5 trillion economy in India by collaborating with the right minds, being part of different ventures in whatever capacity I can, and build meaningful product and processes, and identifying IP in the process, protecting them, doing some kind of licensing work. Licensing is all to do with negotiation. Say, for example, Amazon is investing in Bharti Airtel, where they are talking about $2 billion, or the negotiation table, it might increase to $3 to $4 billion. So that's what negotiation is all about. And playing with the new age tools is my passion, whether it's IoT, AI, ML, big data and related technology, or I would say the deep tech technology, because in the current times, you would see every technology, we like it or not, is coming online in some way or the other. And if you're able to resonate with that, I think you get to learn a lot, and you learn throughout your life, I think, which makes me happy at the end of the day. This is how I have branded myself. Now, I think at the end of the day is Lakshmi. That's what we are seeking, you know, the power to learn and earn. So if you see, when you learn in the right manner and you just take out the L's, that's where you start earning. So we are living a journey of infinite miles. There's no beginning and there's no end, because even if you are a content creator at any given point of time, you have to make the choices. And when you make the choices which is right for you at that point of time, that leads to a path of awesomeness. And that's what resonance is all about. That's what business is all about. Any venture capitalist or anybody or any stakeholder, if you're looking for funding, even from your friends and family, the first question they will ask you is, what is the ROI? What is the investment, and how you are going to give them that added advantage of earning? So you have to answer those questions once you are thinking of being an entrepreneur. So thank you so much, everyone. Dr. Shiv, do you want me to play that video?
Yeah, we can try, yes.
Can you see it?
No, you have stopped the screen sharing.
Okay, I have to stop. Okay, so
if the video is in your system, you can directly play from the system. Then you can do the screen sharing.
Okay, let me just... Can you see it now?
I can see it. So yeah, it is running now. Yes.
Let me just.
रौला जाना पाओ।